It's your boy Indian Gooner in the house. Well, we were mauled by Liverpool. Mauled, yes. The best player in the pitch was the referee for Liverpool. I think he gave soft penalties. There may be a push from Sid Kolasinac, but I think this is English Premier League and we're not playing women's soccer anymore. So I think a little push is okay. And most importantly, the Salah one. I don't believe Egypt had another good diver in the name of Mohamed Salah, but it's okay. I think he can definitely participate in Olympics for Egypt. But more importantly, we lost, and our defense was like a deer in front of a tiger. You know, Roberto Firmino, even if he can you know, look from one eye or not, but he did not need any eyes to score that goal. Clinical, he deserved the hat-trick and he played really well. And most importantly, Sadio Mane was really awesome. I don't know, I am an Indian gooner, but I'm, you know, turning into a Liverpool fan because such was the game. They played really well. They responded very well. Ainsley was good with that goal. Aubameyang, where was he? Was he playing? I don't know. And I don't know why Alexander Lacazette was not introduced in the initial. I really didn't understand the fact. I think Unai Emery was saving Alexander Lacazette for whom? I don't know. It just looked like we just went there to get killed, and we were shot by five arrows straight right there into our hearts. We managed to score the first goal of the game. That was really, really comprehensive in terms of achievement, because we were the only team in the league who scored the first goal at Anfield, and Liverpool were conceding. We lost because of our defensive errors. We just need to get rid of Laurent Koscielny, Stefan Lichtsteiner, and most importantly, that referee. Really, really pathetic. I think Arsenal did not get anything out of, you know, not even a single free kick properly in terms of the way the referee was playing the game. He played really well, and yeah, congratulations on two penalties, ref. Bastard. Anyways, the simple way that we can actually come up is, I don't know what are the plans of Unai Emery. If ever Benega is actually coming to Arsenal, dude, get up and get us some defenders, at least one, so that we save our asses and, you know, at least challenge Chelsea for that fourth spot. And I know that Tottenham may or may not bottle it up, but I think there's a chance that we may enter the Champions League through Europa. I think that's the priority of Emery right now, and not the league, because it doesn't make any sense to not play Lacazette fully 90 minutes in the last two games. Savage draws, Savage a loss, but at the end of the day, not playing him the full 90 minutes against Liverpool, I don't know, that did not make sense to me. Alex Iwobi was really good. Sid Kolasinac in bits and pieces, it was okay. Torreira was really pocketed today. He tried to, you know, there were certain periods of the game where he was really trying to make sure that you know, he'd be clinical, but Liverpool were really over them. I think when one Arsenal player got the ball, five were already hovering around him so that he could not pass it back front. I know he has to lose the ball. And Ben Leno, really, really hardworking person in the whole Arsenal team, because he was a scapegoat. I won't blame him. I think there are defensive errors. This will happen every time we face the top 4-5 teams. We are the 5th team, and soon maybe we may turn up to be the 6th one. So I just hope Unai Emery resolves this defensive problems, because Skodran Mustafi was removed and we bring in Laurent Koscielny. You know, we are in a very, very big mess. The mess is the Wenger mess. We are still in that. To get out of it, I think we need two or three transfer windows. But the one which is coming right after 2 days, we need to get a defender. Cheers!